this is Amos. Well, the other day, there was quite a little excitement up at the Kingfisher's house. And Sapphire was plenty worried about it.
Yes, Mama, George had a terrible night. Yes, the doctor's in there with him now.
Oh.
Yes, oh yes, I was up with him half the night.
Oh.
Huh? Yes. Yes, I'll call you just as soon as the doctor leaves. All right. Yes, all right, goodbye.
That hurts. I think my heart stopped beating about an hour ago.
Tell me the worst, Doctor. I can take it.
My dear Mr. Stevens, at this time, you are suffering from hyposaturation of the duodenum.
Doctor, is he all right?
Mr. Stevens, your husband is suffering from hyposaturation of the duodenum. Mr. Stevens, that's the medical term for overeating. Good day, ma'am.
Oh, Sapphire! Oh, the pain, the pain. I'm going, Sapphire. I'm going. Oh, my Juno, dear. It's getting dim. It's getting dim.
Listen here, George Stevens. I just spoke to the doctor. There ain't a thing wrong with you except overeating.
Now, wait a minute here. I'm a sick man.
Sick man, nothing. You had no business stuffing yourself the way you did at Mama's house last night.
Now, wait a minute here. If I is sick, it ain't how much I eat, it's what I eat. The food she put on that table and had the nerve to call it chicken, it wasn't nothing but rabbit.
Now, you know very well that was chicken.
Well, then why did she hold it by the ears when she was carving it?
Now, listen here, George Stevens.
Now, don't holler at me, honey. Honey, I'm a sick man. A sick man.
Well, all right, George. Now, you get yourself some rest.
But, honey,
you'll be all right by tomorrow.
Did any of my friends call to see how I was?
Ain't been a call all morning.
That's funny. It looked like some of the brothers would inquire. After all, when a fella got as many friends as I had, you would think...
George Stevens, you ain't got a friend in the world, not one friend.
Now, wait a minute here. What about my old buddy Andy?
I wouldn't call Andy no friend. He's just too stupid to see through you. George Stevens, you ain't got no friends. Don't you realize that you have cheated and gypped and swindled every friend you ever had?
But, Sapphire...
One of these days, you're going to realize that you can't go through life without the respect of others. The way you're acting, I don't see how your conscience lets you get away with it.
Me and my conscience got an agreement. It don't bother me, and I don't bother it.
Conscience, George.
Well, what are you bothering me for?
George, Sapphire is right. You have no friends.
Now, wait a minute. I've got friends. People love me.
George Stevens, nobody loves you. You've got to mend your ways.
They gotta love me. They gotta. Conscience, I'll change.
George!
Don't touch me! Don't touch me! I'll change. Sapphire!
George, what's wrong? Is you having a nightmare?
Out of my way, woman. I got work to do. I got friends to make. I'm gonna make friends. I'm turning over a new leaf. I'm gonna make a new life for myself. Farewell.
Oh,
But I think I make more friends with my pants on. My old two-headed coin.
You sure have thrown a lot of stuff away, Mr. King.
Yeah, Lightning, turned over a new leaf. I'm getting rid of all this old stuff so temptation won't be in my way. Six deeds to Central Park. Yeah. I remember the first year I was in New York, I must have sold that thing four or five times.
Yeah, I remember. I owned it once myself.
Well, there'll be no more of that. I was doing fine with that out at the World Fair until one day my head blowed off. Yeah, Lightning? Take all this stuff out and burn it.
Yeah, sir. I will right on out with
it. Hand me down my walking cane. All my sins have been taken away. Oh, do 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 do. East Alaskan canneries. East Alaskan. Oh, yeah, I remember. I had them printed up four or five years ago. They went over big at the time, too. Hand me down my walking cane.
Hiya, Kingfish.
Well, good morning, Brother Andy. How is my good friend this morning? Just sit right down there, son, and make yourself comfortable. Yeah, you got a little dust on you there, boy.
Hey, Kingfish. I just dropped over here to ask your advice. It's about a financial matter.
I'm sorry, Andy, but I done turned over a new leaf, and I wish you wouldn't.
You see, I got a few bucks ahead, and I think about making an investment. Stocks or something.
I know, Andy, but you see, the thing is...
Tell me, Kingfish, you's a smart fella. Does you know any good stocks I can buy? Oh, I just want to buy a few shares, and I'll pay cash.
Yeah, Andy, but you see, the thing is, you see... You want to buy a few shares? Excuse me a minute, Andy, while I step in the clothes closet over there. Be right back.
Conscience. Conscience. Conscience, where is you? Conscience. Can't you hear me? Conscience. Something just come up.
There's a fella out there that's really asking for it.
Conscience. If you don't answer me, I'm going to do it. Conscience. Say something. Conscience.
Well, no news is good news. Well, Brother Andy, you were saying something about stock.
Yeah. Do you know where I can buy a few good shares?
Andy, old pal, it just so happens that I own two shares of Gilt Edge blue chip stock myself.
Oh, well, where has you got the stuff, Kingfish?
Well, let me see. Is they in my vault down at the bank? Or did I give them to my broker for safekeeping? Oops-a-daisy. Here they is, right here in the trash basket. There you is, Andy, the finest stock on the market today. East Alaskan canneries.
East Alaskan canneries?
Yeah, Andy, this is going to be one of their biggest years. Yeah, they really got a surplus of salmon up there on the Yukon.
Yeah, well, why has they got more salmon this year than they got salmon last year?
Oh, for a good reason, Andy. You see, it was just this year that the Alaskan government legalized spawning. Yeah, Andy. There's so many salmon up there that they swim around for 3 or 4 days just looking for a factory that ain't too busy to catch them. Now, let me tell you about it, son. I was there overproduction, and these two shares...
60, 70, 80, 90, 200 bucks.
There you is, Andy. You are now a bona fide stockholder in that great company, East Alaskan Canneries. You'll never regret this, Andy. You made a great deal. And from here on, every time a salmon lays an egg, it's money in the bank for you.
Don't come sneaking around here in the middle of the night yelling at me. Why wasn't you in the closet when I needed you?
George, you cheated Andy. You've lost your last friend.
Well, so what? I don't need no friends.
George, don't you know the old saying, when you pass on and no one mourns you, you'll never rest in peace?
Now, wait a minute, Conscience. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
No. No! Oh!
George, stop it! You're having another one of them nightmares. George, where are you going?
I gotta see Andy right away.
George, you can't go out at this time of night. You get back in bed.
Honey, I gotta talk to Andy. I gotta have friends to mourn me. I gotta.
George, what are you talking about?
Honey, if my funeral was a flop, I'd be unhappy for the rest of my life. Andy, wake up, Andy. Wake up, Andy, let me in. Let me in, Andy. Andy, I just gotta see you, son. I just gotta. Andy, I gotta see you. I gotta see you, son.
Higby, what do you want this hour tonight?
Look, Andy, I gotta talk to you.
Fine time of night to be bothering a fella. What's up, Kingfish?
Andy, that stock I sold you, East Alaskan Cannery, you gotta give it back. Here's the money, son. Here's the money. Andy, you gotta let me have it back. That stock ain't no good.
Ain't no good? What about all them salmon that's been laying eggs in my bank account? Kingfish, is this some angle you got to get in that stock back from me?
No, Andy. I ain't got no angle. My conscience is hurting me, boy, for jipping you. Andy, you just got to let me have it back.
Oh.
Andy.
Let go my nighty, Kingfish. Kingfish, you ain't getting that stock back. This is just one of your schemes. You done found out that stock is worth more than you thought it was.
Now, wait a minute, dear friend, old pal.
Old pal, nothing. Kingfish, I've been knowing you for 22 years. And for 22 years, you've been jipping me. But this time, I see through you. You ain't getting that stock back. This is one flounder that's been gaffed for the last time.
No, Andy, I'm doing it because I love you.
Kingfish, you does not love me.
I tell you I love you, and I mean it.
Kingfish, you don't love nobody.
Andy, don't contradict me when I says I love you. That's that.
You does not love me.
I do, too.
You does not.
Andy Brown, you tell me one more time that I don't love you, and I'm going to take my fist and pound your head right through that brick wall.
You going to punch who?
I'm going to punch you.
Oh.
All right, you big dummy. I'll fix you. I asked you to do this, Amos, because I love you.
Now, listen, Kingfish. I don't know what crooked scheme you got in mind. But I ain't going to Andy and be a party to getting that stock away from him. Now, Kingfish, I got to get back to my cab.
Amos, you got to do this for me. It's a matter of life or death. Are you my friend, Amos?
Now, just a minute, Kingfish. When it comes to friendship, I think you've kind of overused that word all your life. I don't think I was really your friend, and you knows it.
What is you talking about, Amos? You know I loves you, boy. You know I loves you.
Well, now, just a minute, Kingfish. I was afraid I can't believe that you really loves me.
Amos, when I tell you I love you, I'm serious. I'm sincere.
Now, I just don't go for that.
Amos, when I tell somebody I love them, I mean it.
Listen, I just said you don't mean it.
Now, see here, wise guy. You contradict me one more time when I tell you I love you, and I'm going to take my fist and reshuffle that face of yours.
You don't love me.
Now, let me get this straight, Kingfish. Just why has you come to me to get the stock back from Andy?
Because I love you, Calhoun. Because I love you.
Kingfish, I don't want no part of this.
Listen, Calhoun, you just gotta help me get that stock back. After all, you're my pal. You're my friend.
Me, your friend?
Why, certainly, Calhoun, you're my pal. And I love you, boy. I love you. Now, look here, Calhoun. If you don't stop smirking when I tell you that I love you, them teeth of yours, they're gonna be smiling at me from the other side of the room.
Now, wait a minute. You gonna do what to who?
I said, if you say once more that I don't love you, that's the last thing you're gonna ever say.
You don't love me.
That's you, George?
Yeah, honey. It's me.
George! What on earth happened?
Honey, I think I done had too much love for my fellow man.
George, it's time to get up. I know that you have been right. A man like me...
A man like me don't deserve friends or a wonderful wife like you. And so, my darling, I have leave him forever. And I hope those who scorns me now will someday come to think of me with kindness. Yours forever, George. P.S. It wasn't the plumber. I was the one who took the $12.50 out of the cookie jar.
Kingfish gone. I'm gonna make a lot of changes around here.
Did you read about the Kingfish photos?
Ah, that's just another one of the Kingfish's tricks.
Yeah, he's pulled that disappearing act before.
Kingfish could be.
I tell you, fellas, we just gotta do something about the old Kingfish.
Yeah. Boys, I never realized how much I missed him until now.
Yeah. For all his faults, I guess we all did really love him.
We got to get him back, boy. I propose that we take up a collection from all the brothers and post a reward.
A reward?
Yeah. We just got to get our dear, sweet, lovable, conscientious Kingfish back.
missing persons bulletin. Be on the lookout for one, George Kingfish Stevens, 182 pounds, 5'10", who was last seen on Highway 77, may be headed for California. A $500 reward has been posted.
What did it say? It is about the Kingfish. Hey, listen to this. This is to inform you that we have located the missing person you have been seeking through police channels. We fear that... Fella, they done located the Kingfish.
Holy mackerel, where is it?
Wait a minute. One of their operators located the Kingfish working somewhere out in the Middle West there.
Is Mr. Kingfish coming back?
Now, let's see here. Mr. Stevens has expressed his intention of returning to New York. And he's getting there day after tomorrow.
What else did that say, Amos?
I trust this is the information you have been seeking. Yours very truly, Lieutenant H.R. Baker, Baker Detective Agency, Box 32, Jersey City, New Jersey.
Oh, boy, the Kingfish is coming back. The Kingfish is coming back.
Hey, listen, I better run right up there and tell Sapphire.
Fellas? It's gonna cost us $500 to get the old Kingfish back. But it's worth it.
I'm so happy!
No, Kingfish, I sure am glad to see you back.
And that goes for all of us, Kingfish.
You said it, Calhoun. Yeah.
Well, folks, you don't know how good it is to be back home among your dear, dear friends. I love you all.
Now.
Well, George, I guess you're happy now.
I is, to be back with my friends.
Yes, George, I guess after all is said and done, you've learned your lesson. And underneath it all, you do have some fine qualities. And now, George, I won't bother you anymore. Anymore.
Bye, Conscience. Bye.
That sure was a great party last night, wasn't it, Amos?
Yeah. I don't know when I've had so much fun. It sure was great to get the Kingfish back, wasn't it?
Yeah.
By the way, where is the Kingfish this morning?
Oh, he said he had some things to take care of. He'd be down later this afternoon. I guess he kind of tuckered out.
Yeah. It's kind of like old times around here again. I sure glad they located the Kingfish. I was just talking to the lodge secretary. And she done sent a registered letter to Lieutenant Baker with the reward money.
Registered letter, box 32. 32. Mm-hmm. This must be the registered letter you've been expecting, Lieutenant Baker.